sector. We are here to say to the world that we are not comfortable with the way the educational sector of this country is being managed. And to a very large extent, the effect of that is that this country has no future. But as young people that believe that we are doing everything possible to secure a future for ourselves, we are here to make a statement, especially to the government of this country, that we are tired with the way they are managing the affairs of the educational sector. We are tired of having the educational sector underfunded. Imagine a country that is funding the education with less than 10%. Specifically, in 2017 budget, it was funded with 7.4%. In 2018 budget, as we have now, what is pegged there is 7%. And as against what we used to have in 2013, 2014, and 2015. Specifically in 2015, we have budgeted provision made for educational sector of about 15%. But today it has declined. And again, successive leadership has always demonstrated a political ill will towards the development of the educational sector. You go to our campuses, what you see is the dilapidated structure. Again, that in the international community, they don't see our educational sector as one that dish out certificates to people who don't even merit it. Lack of laboratories, lack of libraries, lack of the basic amenities. And yet we have leaders who enjoyed free and compulsory education, who even complained to us that when they were in school like us, they had free education. They had hostel accommodation. But today, that they were even fed with chicken and fish, that to some extent they want to protest that they are being fed with too much of chicken, that they are tired. But today, we are left not only to cater for our school fees, but also to pay for our accommodation on campuses. We pay for TP, we pay for teaching, we pay for things we can see, and we pay for those things we cannot even see. Good apology to our leader, great fella Nicola Poputi, who once said, our people fear for the things they see and for the things they don't see. For us as Nigerian students, we are no longer afraid of those things. We are here to say to government at all levels, both state and federal governments, that enough is enough. Fund the educational sector with nothing less than 26% as recommended by UNESCO. And that is that to the extent that they must give priority to education. If any nation must grow, it must fund the educational sector properly. And we are saying again today, as one of our positions, one of our resolutions, that the ASU and COASU crisis that has lingered for too long must come to an end. We are calling that the government must immediately dissolve the committee, the negotiation committee, that is headed by Mr. Wale Babalakin. We are saying we no longer have confidence in them. We are saying Nigerian students are saying we are tired. Everyone is tired. Our parents are tired of this indiscriminate school fees increment. Just a few months ago, you see some state governments increasing school fees from less than 40,000 naira to 250,000 or 300,000 naira. Where do you expect people that earn less than 20,000 naira, specifically 18,000 minimum wage, to get such funding to educate their children, to educate their world? I think that is calling for corruption. We are saying enough is enough, that government should do everything possible to stop the spate of corruption by properly funding education. If educational sector is well funded, all the problems we have in this country, to a very large extent, will be resolved. All the greatest Nigerian students, all the greatest Bosa, all the greatest Bibi, we are saying today that we are here to collaborate, to collaborate with our international counterparts, to mark the International Students' Day, and of course, as a follow-up to the ultimatum we initially issued to the federal government on the state of the educational sector. We are saying it is not only good to declare state of emergency on the educational sector, but there must be proactive steps to making sure that the educational sector is made better. We are using this opportunity to tell the state governments that enough is enough on the commercialization of the educational sector. We are saying that all the state-owned institutions that their school fees have been increased must be returned back to status quo. Of the greatest Nigerian students, yes. Is that what we are saying?
Yes.
Is that what we are saying?
Yes.
Is that what we are saying?
Yes.
Again, we are saying that those of our members that have been politically victimized, expelled for reasons best known to the management of government, we are saying we call for their immediate reinstatement.
Yes,
we are saying we are saying we request for the immediate reinstatement of those members because they have not done anything wrong. It is because of the high-handedness of the management of those institutions and government interest. That is why we call it political, that they must be reinstated immediately. Of the greatest Nigerian students, in the spirit of justice and equity, we call that the president will see this sector as the most vibrant sector, because education is the bedrock of any nation. No nation can develop without education. Of the greatest Nigerian students, we are saying that the 2018 budget, the president should immediately review it and make it not less than 26%. For us to be able to get it right, 7% is not acceptable. 7% is not acceptable. It is ridiculous, it is undermining, it is undermining, it is unacceptable. And of course, we are saying, for a country like our nation, for a country that has so much resources, that has so much population, we are saying it is sheer wickedness by government to fund education with 7%, and it is high level of misplacement of priority of the greatest Nigerian students. Yeah. At this point, I want to stop as we proceed. But again, let me appreciate the leadership of NLC that are taking part in this. That
we have got by struggle, by struggle.
Research institute institutions are completely and totally underfunded, starting from tertiary education, secondary and primary education. And the fact remains that if we don't do something about our education, we are definitely not going to do anything about our future, because that's where the future of the country lies.
So what demands are we making today?
First of all, as organized labor, we share, because first of all, this program is initiated by NAMS, but we share in the belief of what they are pursuing. What we are saying today is that, first, the attitude of the ruling class, from the federal to state to local government, must change about education. For example, we had recently the governor's mounting about the need not to pay minimum wage to save money for education. First, we know that in most states, even children in primary school sit in bare floor. And it's so much fun, if you check what states have budgeted for education that never got to the people, it's massive. But outside that, when you talk about education, really, serious nations like Norway, which have about the best education system in the world, have a system where in the primary schools of 30 students or 30 pupils, you have 4 teachers, because you need those engagement, those clarity about the children. If you don't lay those foundation, all others will be a waste. But today, even up to the university levels, you find out that most of our campuses in finance are now glorified buildings, because even hostels to stay doesn't exist. Classrooms, some of the classrooms, students stand up to listen to lectures. Not even a place to write from. No country can move forward like that. It is not possible to have a country. Even the psyche of the student that lives in such an environment is already distorted.
Thank you so much.